yes, changing world has got sudden, non-changing also. I need to pray my guru. I need to thank my colleagues who have come also here, who are responsible for the great work which has been recognized world over. And I must say my gratitude to my institution, which is still keeping me in the job, even after retirement in 2003. And my friend and constant companion, Bhagavad Gita. Mission has given me great recognition. I was recognized by our ex-president, Abdul Kalam, and I received a Tech Icon Award from the Prime Minister, 2015. And I've been recognized as amazing Indians. And one of the great work which has been done, I also agreed by the mass media. Recently, I was awarded Uday Singh Award by the King of Mewar. And my work has been patented and has been given a IFSC coding also. And recently, central government has given a notification that here further only plastic roads be laid. There's something about from a scratch, you have come to something very important level because of the very simple work. So I always introduce myself. A waste becomes useful because of another waste. The first waste is myself. And over the period, the plastic waste has been used in a very useful manner. Now I have become useful even for the TEDx. A changing world, I can just imagine the form of a house. And any house has got a foundation. The foundation has to be very stable. Over that, you may have the living face in different form. But the base is very important over which you have the construction. But anyhow, the world has got two aspects. One is dharma as well as nature law. The other is adharma and greed and so on. So how we are going to compete with these two things? Very important. So see here, we had a very in the early period of our 19th century, 20th century, we had our world war. And there is, we talk about the world war and there is industrial revolution and so on. I'm going to look at it in a different plane actually. Before the war, what was the condition? And after the war, what was the condition? Before the war, the innovations were very simple, happy. What is the need to the common man? And there was a cooperative way of looking at this. Live and let live was a concept. After the war, the need has increased. It has become a greed. And the result, more and more of industrial development taking place. And it was a competitive, cooperative way, it is a competitive way, creating more problems now. With the result, yesterday people, I say what I mean by yesterday, 1,000 years back, people lived happily with the limited facilities available. And there was no pollution, nothing has happened. Now today, we have all the comforts, wonderful. We have all the materials available, whatever needed. But at the same time, the environment is hazardous, highly pollution. We are talking about global warming. Probably you may not feel here. It is when I come out from Madurai to this place, the warmth, I feel so much about that. All these things because of the industrial development, which you say is very important, now create a problem. If the same thing has continued in the changing world, if we don't take care of this, what will happen in the next 50 years? You will be dumped with only with waste plastics and waste materials only around. Industrial waste is going on increasing like anything. Therefore, it's very important we take care of it. And see here, in the world, there are 84 lakhs living beings available. Only one is a human being. This one man makes all the change for his convenience, for his comfort only. He has developed so many things, starting from cosmetics, drugs, fertilizers. So many materials have been developed here. And what for all those things? For his own, he feels that it is worth for convenience. Whether they actually it has helped him in, probably it has helped his standard of living, but not otherwise. All those industries have ultimately accumulated more and more of waste in the surroundings only. And here, the industry, the research, there are two types of research. One is appropriate research, the other one is advanced research. You are more interested in going Mars, you're going interested in something doing that way. But what is happening to the common man? What is happening to the world? India has got about more than 65% of villages. What we do with that, nothing has been to happen. Only we talk about industrial evolution. But actually, what happened to the philosophy? The industrial philosophy is different. Produce, market it, and forget it. And domestic people consume it, throw it, forget it. And the government collect it, dump it, forget it. I just have one example here. Everybody is using toothpaste. Do you know what toothpaste you are using? Do you know why that toothpaste you are using? Do you know what it contains? What do you do daily, you know? Every day you take 2 grams of paste and then use it and then spit it on the ground. That contains 50% of calcium carbonate. And every day you are adding calcium carbonate to the water. What will happen? Automatically water getting enriched in hardness. We are polluting our own water. And what anybody bothers about it? Nobody bothers about it. And the tube which you use, what do? You simply throw it. You know, the simple ballpoint pen refill alone, per year, you get about 1 lakh tons of refill alone that has been thrown away. If that is the case, how much of plastic is being wasted? Or been thrown away? Who is caring about that? So the philosophy itself, forgetting. Nobody bothers about what is going to be next. Next generation, what will be happening? So we need to have, think about the Mother India, the Mother World. Mother World already running with fever by 2.5 degree more. And Mother India supplies oxygen. We give back only carbon dioxide. They give food, we give all trash material, all toxic material. So day by day we are adding only negative aspects to the world only. This is what the changing world is going on. If this continues, what will be the life? What will be the nature of the life? What will be the environment? It's very, very important to think about it. Somebody should take it. Definitely we must take it about very seriously. Think about it. And here is the whatever may be the situation, we need a clean environment. We need good food. We need enough place for living. And we need to live with the available materials that we need not to get Rajasthan material for our household construction. We can have our own construction here, which is very convenient for that. Like that is very, very important that we need to try to know how to live in this world also. We should not be simply greedy about our living. So, a relook is important in this changing world. And relook as a rethinking. People used to say reduce, reuse, recycle. Unless you rethink about it, you cannot think about those things. What you do that? Thinking means, I say not innovation, I say innovation. What do you mean innovation is? Indian way of innovation is very, very important. We need to know. See, I had a visitor from Madhya Pradesh. And about 20 people came and told me, sir, we don't have method of crushing our wheat into powder or mechanical means. There is no energy, light energy, current energy available here. So kindly give me a method by which handmade method we can make it into powder. That is the world which are living. What we are going to do? We must make a method by which we can try to develop, which is innovation. We can see something like that, and it should be appropriate to change, more suitable for a common man. This is possible only if you own yourself. You know what you are, where you are, how you are, in which country you are living, where is the place. Unless you understand, you are the person who may be industry, you are the person who may be in the government, but unless you know what you are and what to do with that is very important. Ownership and everything only changes you in many directions. So, and that the institute, in the educational institution, play a very important role. They have to interact with the industry, they have to interact with society, they have to interact with the government. And today, the atmosphere is very good. Swachh Bharat is there. They say they are ready to interact with very well. So that can be a helpful hand for the changing world. See here, and one more thing is, industrial, all the departments put together should interact. There cannot be an island of one department to another department. Each department can contribute. Today I'm standing here because I was a chemistry professor once, but I don't know what I am now. Because I interacted with so many people and I have addressed the chief engineers of India. A chemistry professor addressing chief engineer in India is possible because of inter-departmental work only. It is possible, and therefore, change in attitude is important. What is the change in attitude? You see, first of all, let us try to think about, we always know our banner is go green. Don't say go green. Let us say come green. Because we have been planned, we have all been tutored like that. Rain, go away, come again, another. That was about 50, 60, 70 years back, westernized rhyme was here. But we should not use that because we don't have rain today. Rain, go away, but come in. No, we must only welcome our green atmosphere. We have done a small way in this process. And what I have done now, a small contribution in my level, I have found out a method of using waste plastic into road. And my road, which has been laid in 2002, till today functioned very well. Even after 15 years, the road is never developed, even a crack, not even a pothole has been formed. And in the process, we are trying to use large amount of plastic. If all the roads in India, about 40 to 41 lakhs kilometers in India, have been converted to plastic road, we don't have enough plastic today. And we have to have plastic imported from other countries, that is the present condition. Similarly, using the waste plastic, we have developed another material called plastone, which will show here. I have brought a sample also, which is very important, which is a new material of its own kind. It can withstand 300 tons load without any crushing. Even if you crush more, it never breaks, it only extends. New type of material, which is not available in the world. And we have developed e-waste, which is now creating all the problem. We have used the e-waste, convert it into bituminous material, and that is again being used for road laying. So it is very easily possible. So road, very simple use of waste plastic, roads, better road, saving bitumen, cost less, solid waste, manure is obtained. Job is possible, and see here, this is a simple method, aggregate, heating to 107 degree, adding waste plastic. Just 30 seconds more, we are able to do the whole process, and this is the road, just 30 seconds extra. We have made the road, and the road cost is less, bitumen saved, and environmental is friendly. And we have developed another product called plastone. This is made up of only plastic and stone, nothing else. No cement, no water, no bitumen, nothing. But this can withstand 300 loads. This can get enormous application. It is being used all solid waste, from limestone and ceramic waste, concrete debris waste, and granite. Each company is throwing a lot of waste material to the either sea or the river. We are trying to prevent all those things. All of them made wonderful material. And that is where the various uses which you have got for this material. And this is the central government project we are doing that. We are going to help to construct low-cost toilet. And this is being done only from the plastone only. And we have developed a bituminous material which is used from e-waste. Therefore, it's very easy. All these waste are not a waste. No, it is a wonderful resource for us to develop into newer material. And therefore, it is very important that we need to have a care for the environment. Everybody must see. I used to, whenever anybody comes to my room, I give 2 chocolate. And everybody, I just will be watching. They will ask, is it your birthday? I said, no, just I'm giving as a gesture. And I just observe what they do. They take the chocolate and they put it and the paper, they crush it. And I have got 2 dustbin on both sides. Nobody uses the dustbin. They use my table as a dustbin or they put it on the down. This is the culture, therefore. Care for the environment is very important. Care for our country is very important. And that's why Swachh Bharat, Make in India, very, very convenient. Now we are able to do more and care for yourself. And India has got wonderful opportunity. India has got all the facilities. Challenges are there in many fields. Food technology, fertile technology, there are many, many technologies which is more suited for India. Therefore, it is very important that we need to go for our own requirement, our own knowledge, and therefore, simply we can do. I started my whole test in a kitchenware, and now today, with a penniless man, I was there in 2001. Today, my lab is more than 2.5 crores worth. All those things with the waste plastic provided me, all those things. And my lab is the best lab now in Tamil Nadu. This is the best lab for road testing as well as plastic testing. I have all the instruments, only the plastic has given, and has given a job also. See, even now, I'm a dean. All those things because of that. Therefore, there is an opportunity for a job. There is more need for your help in this direction. Therefore, the most interesting I would like to add here is our education system has to be changed. And here, we need to know more about, from the textbook, you must go for a hands-on work. So 50% we can have one day the test, the rest will be hands-on. Unless you feel how to work, how to understand, how these things will work, it is very difficult. Therefore, it is very important. Therefore, the educational technology, education technique has to be changed. And if that is changed, definitely it's possible. This is beautifully expressed in Bhagavad Gita, Sakayagya Prachasvishta Purovacha Prachapati Anena Prashavishtam Yesho Ishtakamatam. The world is friendly. It is very easy to you interact with you. Don't be greedy. Whatever you need, the world is ready to give. What you need to do is you try to be in coordination with the world. The world will be Kamadhanu, which will it will ready to give whatever you want. Devan Bhavayati De Devo Bhavayantaha Parasparam Bhavayantaha Sreha Vatsaha. Being friend to that, mutual thanking each other, you thank the nature, nature will thank you, you will get everything. Therefore, that is the technology which we need to follow in the changing world to make us happy. And therefore, we have, I always put this as a symbol for me, a logo for me, I'll put it, because Brahma created plastic, yet to show me how to decompose it. Shiva is waiting for that. But Brahma, Vishnu has shown me what we can do with the plastic in a constructive way. We have developed road, we have developed blocks, we have developed modified bitumen, we have developed roofing material. There are many things to be done. See, I just had give one more detail about that. Every day we use cooker in our house. Do you know what is the efficiency of the cooker? Not even 50%. Can we not modify the cooker to improve the efficiency of that? It is very important. We need to modify the design of the cooker. We need to modify the burner, and nobody bothers about. For the past 20, 25 years, the same design is going on. How to do, what to do, very important. Therefore, unless you own yourself to the country, you can't develop. I request you people to take more interest in this respect. Definitely, we can make the country. What is not available in this country, everything available. Let us make the country prosperous. Thank you very much for this great opportunity. And this is my address. I'm always available for 24 this time. Thank you very much.